My name is Emelina Manne, the principal of Dagbreek Primary School. I've been a teacher for 33 years. Welcome to this school, the school which has a rich culture, the school that is having teamwork, collaboration, and you know, innovative educators and learners. You are welcomed from the school culture group. During the COVID, the level 5, it was dead. Initially, we had this WhatsApp group for all the educators. We were communicating while at home. And the problem is our learners are from the disadvantaged families. They don't have the gadgets. You know, even this, the education that is given by the department in TVs, some don't even have a TV in the house. So we had a problem. I was worried that now that our kids are at home, it's level 5, there's nothing we can do. We could not communicate with the learners. We were just communicating amongst us as educators saying, you know, we are here depressed, there's nothing we can do. And then, the technological part mostly was affected because we don't have any means to talk to learners while they are not at school. The sources of interventions that I've put in place was when I called the priests. You know, they can pray, they can talk to the people. So the priests were coming. I was inviting different priests from different churches to come. So they will preach. After preaching, they will interpret the scriptures. And then after that, mainly the focus was on COVID. To say, don't think you are alone. We are all in this one. But what is key is for us to support each other and to know that there is one person who's looking after us. I want to see Dagbreek with everything that we've been doing, improving the celebrations that we had. You know, as you can see, we were always ushering our guests with the tramajorettes. And then we've got the sports, that's now suspended a little bit. We've got the sports, the netball there. We've got learners that can do traditional dances. We've got the boys that can do gumboot dance. It's a lot of things. And then the learners were participating, doing items in the classrooms. And then also the dancing part, the music part, you know. You know, we've got projects, these projects. You know, they want to change the learners' mindset. They want learners to be employable. They want learners to be creative, do things on their own. And they mustn't just focus on getting a certificate and going to look for employment. They must be self-employable. So we use these iPads to change their mindset, to be creative. And you know, they enjoy the iPads so much. And they can use them. You know, you just tell them, get me maybe what is the meaning of drama. You know, they'll just go to drama and tell you this is what is happening. You know, they are so they can do on their own. We thought learners are not intelligent enough to use the gadgets. Learners are more intelligent than us. They know the iPads more than we do. So, you know, I'm happy to see a learner doing something more creative than I can do. I think educators, because of they've got the phones and stuff, ne? And then they are all connected to the Wi-Fi. So they can Google, they can do whatever, but during the lesson, the educator is the one who gives instructions. Learners do, and then afterwards they write whatever instruction says, because I had the one in life skills. I had a lesson in life skills where they want learners to know what is a vision. Learners must know what is a mission. And then learners must know how pets are taken care of. So we Googled, after Googling, we got that they need shelter, they need food, they need water. And then whenever you write the sentence there to say, they need water to drink, you must draw. Also draw a dog maybe drinking water. You know, a shelter, a dog in the shelter, you know, all those, you know, and they are so creative. You must see what they've drawn there. You'll be very much excited. It made me realize that I must focus on the well-being of this group. It's important to look at an individual with his social, emotional stresses and accommodate that individual. So with the Africa Dialogue that I attended, changed me a lot, because now I looked at educators and learners as my own people, as one big family. And then I changed and look at them, you know, as human beings, as people that can only teach if they are happy, as people who can do work while they are taken care of. So most of the things changed. I changed drastically.